this supernatural dimension is anchored in the plants that live in our world. And my brother was a botanist and I had botanical training. As we studied the psychoactive plants of the world, especially the New World tropics, where they seem to be concentrated, we were simultaneously exalted by the realization that we had found a doorway, a real doorway into hyperspace, and at the same time, tremendously upset and alarmed by the fact that this doorway is in the process of being dismantled by the forces of human ignorance that are not even aware of its existence. So this was the impulse behind the decision on the part of my partner Kat and I that these plants must be saved. They must be preserved in germplasm repositories or botanical gardens or something like that, toward a day when they can be studied and the power, the dimensions within them, can be given their real weight. So to this end, we founded a botanical garden in Hawaii that is specifically dedicated to preserving plants with a history of shamanic importance. And I mention this because this is the real world political work that we do, and everything else I will say today will be barely anchored in any world familiar to most of us. But there is a political anchoring, there is a place where it all comes tangential to the World Bank and the IMF and the host governments and so forth and so on. It is tremendously important to preserve this shamanic option, if for no other reason than we do not know what it is. We do not know what it is. Well, so at the break, if you come up, the newsletter of our botanical garden is the large stack of beige paper, and there are 300 copies of that, so I hope there's enough for everyone. We do exist on donations, so if any of you are philanthropists, we can certainly tell you how to spend your money. We have many plans for your money. Okay.